guys, this is Chetan for Gizmo Times and you're watching a quick FAQ about the Realme C3. You guys have been asking questions about this phone. There are a lot of questions that you guys asked, and most of the gaming related questions, we answered them through multiple videos about the gyroscope support, about the 60 FPS support, whether that is possible through GFX tool, about whatever the heating issues are, whether the phone heats up, and about what the G70 is able to offer. So that all was answered, but these are some of the general questions that you guys asked. Let's start with firstly the benchmark scores. So with the G70 chipset, the MediaTek's Helio G70, the gaming related chipset, this one is in the entry level. This is the benchmark score. It's about 192,000 on Antutu benchmark, and for the Geekbench it's 341 for the single core, 1252 for the multi-core. So these are the basic scores for the benchmark test, and Antutu around 2 lakh is not a bad score at all, again for a phone that is priced under 8,000 rupees. This is the 4GB RAM variant. Obviously for the 3GB RAM you might see some lower score, but still it's not a bad score at all. It's quite a decent chipset when we talk about the benchmark scores given here. Next one was about play Fortnite on this phone. This was what most of you guys commented in our previous videos. So this is just to clear it up for you. We installed the Epic Games application to check whether there is support for Fortnite. So you can clearly see here that the device is not supported, and that's what it is about the Fortnite too. So obviously you can't play Fortnite on this phone. Helio G70 is capable of doing some decent gaming on other games, even including PUBG Mobile, but Fortnite is not supported. Next one, the Garena Free Fire. We possibly will be doing a couple of games, a couple of minutes of gaming in this video itself with the Garena Free Fire. Free Fire, you can see towards the end of the video if you are interested to see whether the game is being played well on this phone or not, but we won't do an entire gaming around it because Free Fire is pretty chilled out. It's not something that would need a lot of resources. It can be played on even some basic phones, so obviously there's no issue playing this game, and it was well supported on the Realme C3. Next one was about the FM radio, whether there's support for FM radio. It does have the FM radio pre-installed, so there's no external app needed. It comes as an app, but you need to insert earphones. So this is a difference from the Redmi 8A. Redmi 8A has the wireless FM radio. You don't have to insert the 3.5 headset jack or the headphone there. Here you need to insert the headphone, and once you insert that, then the antenna would get activated and the FM radio would be played. So there is support for FM radio, but it's not the wireless FM radio that is supported here. About the screen protection. The screen protection on the Realme C3 is the Gorilla Glass 3 protection, so it would keep it scratch free, but I would frankly have a tempered glass placed on this one, because if the phone falls, surely the screen is going to get shattered. So it's better to have a tempered glass, but if you're someone who is worry-free about it, who doesn't really care about it, you can have the regular screen guard, or there's a screen guard that comes inside the box itself as a pre-installed one. So that should be good enough to keep it scratch-free. Next is, how is face unlock? So we have used face unlock as the only security feature here. Obviously there is the pattern, pin or password. Apart from that, there is no fingerprint option on this one. So back is plain, and for a budget phone, again, you can't expect fingerprint sensor, because that's what the companies have made as a standard. Even the Redmi 8A did not have it. Even the other basic phones did not have it. This does not have it as well. So the face unlock works pretty well in well lit conditions. In low light does struggle a bit, but then it has the option to compensate the low light with the screen's brightening, and the screen's brightening is doing it well enough, and your face then gets lit up to get easily recognized, and the face unlock does work decently on the Realme C3. Now this was the major question. While we also showed you the gyroscope performance on the PUBG Mobile, but there is one thing about the gyroscope: we don't see it as one of the sensors in the phone. When you check that in the benchmark applications, when you check that in the spec sheet as well, there is a gyrometer, no direct gyroscope, there's a gyrometer, and then there's a magnetic induction sensor. And if you go into the list of sensors, you'll see a virtual gyroscope. So it's not the actual gyroscope that is shown there. So under the sensors, there's the virtual gyro that is shown even in the Antutu benchmark. So obviously it's not a fully functional gyroscope functionality that you get on the Realme C3, but it would take advantage of the virtual gyro and the magnetic induction sensor in the games. So that is why you see that problem with the delay in the gyroscope when you're playing PUBG Mobile. If you had seen our gaming video where we showed you the gyroscope usage, there was always a delay. Whenever you try to shake the device, it would be a delay of about 0.5 seconds. So that delay is because of the absence of the real gyroscope in this device. So you can't play the gyroscope well if you're playing PUBG Mobile and you are a gyro user. You should probably look at some other phones because this phone does not have a very good gyroscope functionality on it. So there was one question about the Realme UI as well, whether the Realme UI on this phone is going to be as good as the other ones, because with the Realme UI, the animations have got much better, the app icons, the way the UI looks like, it has got better. So people are asking whether these animations can be well handled by the Helio G70 chipset. It actually is able to handle it because of the same concept that is used by Realme on the other phones. There's an animation engine that takes care of everything, and everything is smooth enough so far. We have already installed at least 20 applications. We have used the phone properly with the SIM card in it, and there was never an issue with the phone. So it was doing really well. The Realme UI is actually well optimized. So it doesn't matter if you're using a phone that is 6,000 rupees or 7,000 or 12,000 or even the Realme X2 Pro. X2 Pro obviously has to get much smoother than this. So that is a different case. But here it has been smooth enough. There were no issues with the performance. And even with the performance, if you somehow missed it, if you go into the battery settings, in the battery settings, you have a option of performance mode. If you go there, there are three options. One is the high performance mode, where you get more better performance and more power will be consumed. But since it's a 5000 mAh battery, you shouldn't really care about that. Then there's a smart performance mode, where it would automatically improve the performance based on the usage scenario. So it would try to learn. This is where the AI part kicks in. I'm not sure how good it works, but the AI part, what it does is it tries to learn the usage pattern and see which apps are most frequently used. So it would try to deactivate the other ones in the background and then keep the performance on this one. So that is where the smart performance mode is there. And third one is the no performance improvement. This would turn off all the improved performance and this would extend the battery life. So this is for those who use this phone as a secondary one and don't really care about the performance. You need a longer battery life. So there's this performance mode feature under the battery settings, and that would be helping you in getting a better performance if you go to the high performance mode. This is under the battery settings in the settings, and you can change it. So in a way, I'd say that the Realme C3 has a good performance with the Helio G70. The Realme UI is also smooth. But then if you want a better performance, go to the battery settings and set it to high performance mode. Now there was one more question. The final one here in this FAQ is about the performance of this phone compared to the Redmi Note 8, compared to the Realme 5, and compared to even the Xiaomi Mi A3, all of them on the Snapdragon 665. So how comparable is the Helio G70 with the Snapdragon 665? I would say so far, at least with gaming, the 665 actually lags behind this one. It doesn't have features that are present on this phone. So don't think about the pricing here. Think about the chipset. Chipset in particular, the Helio G70 with the Mali G52 GPU is capable of offering better graphic performance when compared to those phones. So if you're someone who's considering a phone for gaming, you should rather go with this one when compared to those. Because those phones, the Realme 5 for example, this has a combination of four cameras. So getting four cameras under 10,000 rupees was actually a pretty good deal. It had a 12 megapixel camera, then a wide angle one, then a 2MP macro camera as well, and then a 2MP depth one. But all those things are not present on the Realme C3. There are two cameras, and one is a depth sensor, one is a main sensor. So that's the difference here. There are many things where the Realme 5 could be better, but with the performance, if that is a major thing for you, you should rather look at the Realme C3 because it actually has a chipset that is delivering a great performance. So that's it. This was a quick FAQ of the Realme C3 smartphone. The major questions answered. If you still have any other questions, do comment below. We'll try to answer them. And I hope you like this video. If you do, subscribe and share this video and stay tuned for more videos. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.